Welcome. I'm Dr. Tina Goudreau-Collison, and I'm excited to show you some of the amazing lab spaces where biochemistry and chemistry students conduct their independent research in the College of Science. We have more than 20 lab spaces in chemistry and biochemistry dedicated to teaching, research, and instrumentation. Here in the Advanced Synthesis Lab, undergraduate students interested in making new and useful molecules conduct their independent research. Nature is the source of many useful molecules, like pharmaceuticals, but nature cannot create these molecules fast enough or in large enough quantity to meet our needs. Organic chemists like me solve this problem by making these molecules in the lab. Students interested in this kind of work become very comfortable using specialized equipment like rotary evaporators, gas line manifolds, or even a glove box. This is exactly the type of synthetic lab you would encounter after graduation in a graduate program or in industry. Now, to learn more about our instrumentation labs, here is Dr. Nathan Ettingsas.
The instrumentation we have in this lab lets us understand what we have, how much we have, and what is happening at the molecular level. Some of the more heavily used instruments include the gas chromatography mass spectrometry, liquid chromatography mass spectrometry, and nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. Students in the School of Chemistry and Material Science can get trained on these state-of-the-art instruments. Once trained, they have access to these instruments whenever they need to. This gives them a unique opportunity to generate data and use these instruments for their own research. Using our instruments, we can study the aerosols generated from electronic cigarettes. Students can use gas chromatography and mass spectrometry to analyze and quantify the nicotine and other harmful components emitted. Here, a student can study small microplastics found in environmental water samples. We use Raman microscopy to identify that plastics are found and to determine how many and what type of polymers are found. I hope you've enjoyed your brief tour of the labs here at RIT. Our students tell us it's what they learn in these labs that set them apart in graduate school, medical school, and seeking positions in industry. I hope to see you around the lab soon.